In this session, we are going to discuss about 8085 architecture. The topics includes data and address bus, accumulator, temporary register, arithmetic and logical unit, flag registers, and general purpose registers. First of all, let's see the important features of 8085. 8085 microprocessor is an 8-bit microprocessor. That means it can handle 8-bit data parallelly at a time. Or in other words, the word length of 8085 microprocessor is 8-bit. And 8085 is built on NMOS technology, that is N-type metal oxide semiconductors. It is an advanced version of Intel 8080 microprocessor. Intel 8080 is an 8-bit processor, and it is driven by a single 5 voltage power supply. In order to operate that one, it requires 5 volt DC supply. The clock frequency of 8085 microprocessor is near to 3 megahertz. Therefore, the time period is 1 by 3 megahertz, that is coming around 320 nanosecond. And it contains 8-bit data bus, that is, the data movement between MIPI and peripheral is carried out through 8-bit data bus. Then it contains 16-bit address bus. 16-bit means its address range is from A0 to A15. So we know there is a relationship between address lines and memory handling capacity. If we can have 16-bit address lines, the memory handling capacity is 2 raised to 16, which is equal to 64K. So if microprocessor is of 16-bit address lines, so it can address up to 64KB memory locations. And another important feature of 8085 microprocessor is it contains accumulator. It is an 8-bit register. So it is very, very important registers during arithmetic and logical operation. Suppose we need to add two numbers, say 80 and 11. So we know the answer is 91. So whenever arithmetic and logical operation is to be carried out, one of the operands should be there in accumulator. Or in other words, in order to perform this particular addition process, one operand, it may be either 80 or 11, should be there in accumulator. And the result, after completing this result is automatically saved in accumulator. So accumulator is an 8-bit register which contains one of the operand during arithmetic and logical operation. And another operand may be in any one of the six general purpose registers. There are six general purpose registers, namely B register, C register, D register, E register, H register, and L register. So we know each registers is 8-bit registers. In 8-bit registers, we can save 8-bit data. In 8085 microprocessor, we can save, there is a possibility of saving 16-bit data also. For that, it is possible to handle register pair. So register pairs are used for saving or handling 16-bit data. So whenever we are saving 16-bit data in register pair, say BC register pair, this 16-bit data contains LSB data and MSB data. LSB 8-bit data and MSB 8-bit data. So when we are considering BC register pair, LSB 8-bit data is usually available in C register, and MSB 8-bit data is available in B register. So this 16-bit data contains LSB 8-bit, LSB 8-bit, and MSB 8-bit, totally 16-bit. So LSB 8-bit data is available in C register, MSB 8-bit data is available in B register. So the possible register pair combinations are BC register pair, DE register pair and HL register. We can't use DC or something like that. So the possible register pair combinations are BC register pair, DE register pair and HL register pair. So among these register pair combination, HL register pair can be used for pointing a particular memory location. So we know in the case of 8085, we can have 16-bit address. So this 16-bit address can be saved in HL register pair when we are using HL register pair as for saving memory location. That is known as a memory pointer. So HL pair can be used as a memory pointer. So if HL pair is used as memory pointer, the content of that memory location is denoted by EM. So whenever we are discussing about instruction, you can see the letter M. So M stands for the content of memory location whose address is available in HL register pair. So default memory pointer in 8085 is HL register pair. So we completed accumulator. So we can have 6 general purpose register. Each can be used for saving 8-bit data temporarily during arithmetic and logical operation. There is a possibility of saving 16-bit data by means of combination of register pair, that is register pair combination. The possible register pair combinations are BC, DE register pair and HL register pair combination. 3 register pair combinations are available. In addition to that one, there are 2 special purpose registers. 2 special purpose registers. One is program counter. So this is coming here. So program counter track the execution of the program. It routines the execution of the program. So we know a particular task is to be done by means of a different instruction written in order. That is known as program. So after execution of an instruction, next instruction will execute, and after that next instruction will execute, and finally the last instruction will execute. So this tracking process is handled effectively by means of a program counter. So program counter contains the address of next instruction to be executed. So actually all the instructions are converted into one machine code, and that machine code is saved in memory location. We know the memory location is having 16-bit address. So program counter contains the address of next instruction to be executed. Where the next instruction opcode is available, that memory location is pointed by program counter. So program counter contains memory locations. In order to save the 16-bit address, we need a 16-bit register. That register is program counter. So program counter contains the address of next instruction to be executed. Address in 8085 is 16-bit long. So PC is of 16-bit wide. So another special purpose 16-bit register is a stack pointer. Stack pointer is used for saving the content of PC during subroutine or interrupt process. Interrupt means, suppose we are doing some work, in between what happens, some urgent task came. What we will do? We will stop whatever be the process which we are doing so far, and we will try to complete the urgent task. And after completing that urgent task, we will restart the work exactly from the same point wherever we stopped. So similar case may come in the case of 8085 microprocessor or in general any processor. So during that condition, suppose a microprocessor is handling main programs, suppose an interrupt came, MUP need to do that work. So before branching into that urgent task, MUP need to save the content of program counter. So we know the content of program counter is the address of next instruction to be executed in main program. Before branching to subroutine or before branching into the urgent task, MuP need to save the content of PC into one location. That location is termed as stack. So stack is a memory location which is used to save our program in a particular fashion. Stack is a memory location which is used to save the content of program counter during interrupt or subroutine. Stack pointer is a 16-bit register which contains the address of the top of the stack. So these two things are very important in 8085 microprocessor. So one is program counter. It contains the address of next instruction to be executed during execution of any program. And next one is another 16-bit register, that is stack pointer, which is useful during subroutine. Subroutine means repeated operation. During subroutine and interrupt process, the content of PC need to be saved into location, and after completing that subroutine or interrupt, MuP need to save back the content of PC which is already saved in stack pointer into PC. So for that we can utilize stack pointer. It is a 16-bit register which contains the address of stack top. So another important feature of 8085 microprocessor is it is a 40-pin DIP, that is dual inline package. These are the important features of 8085 microprocessor. So this is the block diagram of 8085 microprocessor. Here we can see two important things. This is address bus and this is data bus, address data bus. First of all, let's see this one, that is data and address bus. So in the case of 8085, we can have 16-bit address. So when we are considering 16-bit wide, we can write in this fashion, A0 to A15 is the width of the address bus. So in the case of 8085, there is a process known as multiplexing. So multiplexing means time shared operation of some pins. So during one particular time, it is used for sending one particular signal. During another time, the same pin can be utilized for sending another signal. So that process is known as multiplexing. So in the case of 8085, totally we can have 16 address lines. So among these 16 address lines, these AD0 to AD7 LSB address lines are multiplexed. So as the name indicates, AD stands for address data. So during the initial time, it is used for sending address lines. Later, it is used for sending data. These are multiplexed pins. So data bus is 8 bit, so that 8 bit of data can be transferred to and from microprocessor in parallel. Data is transferred from MuP to peripheral or vice versa by means of AD0 to AD7 lines. So here you can see internal data bus. So what is the need of internal data bus? Internal data bus is used to transfer instruction and data among internal registers. We can have so many internal registers here. So between internal registers, we need to transfer data. So for that, we can use internal data bus. Similarly, to access a memory location, 8085 send a 16-bit address. MSB of 8-bit address lines is sent through A8 to A15, and least significant 8-bit address is transmitted through AD0 to AD7 pins. So both data and addresses are transmitted over address data bus. So this is made possible by using address data bus operated in time shared mode. The time shared mode operation of pins are known as multiplexing. During first clock cycle of every machine cycle, address data bus carries low order address. During second and third clock cycles of every machine cycle, it carries data. This is known as multiplexing. So effective width of address bus is 16, so that 8085 is capable of addressing 2 raised to 16, that is 64k memory locations. So address range is from 000h to FFFFH. As we discussed earlier, as address data bus carries both signal, that is address lines, which is from MUP to peripheral, data from MUP to peripheral and vice versa, address data bus is bidirectional and this is unidirectional. So address data bus is bidirectional and address bus is unidirectional. So next important part is accumulator. This is accumulator. So when we are talking about accumulator, it is an 8-bit register. It can send data to internal data bus or receive data from internal data bus. So as we seen here, accumulator is used to send data into internal bus or receive data from internal data bus. So during various ALU operation, that is arithmetic and logical operation, usually one of the operand will be available in accumulator. For example, during addition of two numbers, say 02 plus 03, any one of the operand during ALU operation will be there in accumulator. Another operand may be in any of the registers. See, we can have B register, C register, D, E, H and L register. The 03 may be the content of a memory location. Say 03 is saved in B register. So after adding, the result is 05. After completing this ALU operation, 02 is get replaced with 05. So during addition of two numbers, one of the operand will be there in accumulator. Second operand can be in register. Here we assumed the second operand 3 is available in B register. It may be in memory locations also. And after doing arithmetic and logical operation, results of operation will be stored in accumulator, replacing one of the operand. Another important register is a temporary register. It is again 8-bit register, which is temporarily hold one of the operand during binary operation, arithmetic and logical operation. In this case, earlier case, we added 02 and 03. So during ALU operation, first operand is already available in accumulator. A copy of content of B register is available in temporary register during arithmetic and logical operation or simply binary operation. If the content of register B are added to content of accumulator, then temporary register hold a copy of content of B register while addition is taking place. So that is the important of temporary register. Next important point is arithmetic and logical unit and associated flag flip-flops. ALU carries out all the arithmetic and logical operation. Arithmetic operations means it may be addition, add, it may be subtraction. And in the case of 8085, we can perform multiplication by repeated addition and division can be carried out by means of repeated subtraction and so on. So these are the basic arithmetic operation. Coming to logical operation, we can have AND operation and we can have OR operation is there, XOR operation is there and NOT operation is there. All these, for doing all these things, we can have instruction in the case of 8085. During these operations, ALU operation, as it is clear from this diagram, the input to ALU units are accumulator and temporary registers. So based on the data of accumulator and temporary registers, it can perform all these operations. Result of arithmetic and logical operation is saved back into accumulator through internal data bus. So associated with ALU, there is a 5 set of flip-flops, which is termed as flag registers. Each flip-flops act as flags. A flag indicates condition arises during logical and arithmetic operation. The status flags are sign flag, zero flag. This is don't care. Then auxiliary carry flag. Again don't care. Parity flag is there. Again don't care. Carry. So this is the format of status flag. So associated with ALU there are 5 flip-flops. These 5 status flags are like this. Last MSB is sign flag, zero flag, don't care, auxiliary carry, don't care, parity flag, carry flag. So what is sign flag? If MSB of result of arithmetic operation is 1, it indicates the number is negative. If number is negative, sign flag will set. S will set if MSB of result is 1. If the MSB of result is 0, it indicates the number is positive. Under that condition, sign flag will reset 0. So sign flag is used with signed numbers. So after completing arithmetic and logical operation, if the content of accumulator is 0, then 0 flag will set. If the content of accumulator is not 0, 0 flag will reset. If the result of an arithmetic and logical operation is 0, 0 flag will set. Otherwise, it will reset. So next one is auxiliary carry. Let's consider two 8-bit numbers. 8-bit numbers contains two 4-bit numbers, 4-bit MSB, another 4-bit LSB. Totally, we can have 8-bit data. So this is known as LSB nibble and this is known as MSB nibble. Let's consider a simple example. Say our first number is 0F, second number is 11. Suppose we need to add these two numbers. So this is LSB nibble, this is MSB nibble. For getting a clear idea, let's convert these numbers, 8-bit, two 8-bit numbers into binary form. So first 0 can be represented in 4 zeros. And F can be represented in this way. And this is 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So when we are adding these two numbers, 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1. So 1 plus 1, 0 with carry 1. So 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 0, 1. So answer is 1, remaining are 0. So this is the result. So when we are considering here, so from LSB nibble to MSB nibble, there is a carry. From LSB nibble to MSB nibble during addition operation, there is a carry. That carry is known as auxiliary carry. So whenever an auxiliary carry arises during arithmetic and logical operation, auxiliary carry will set, otherwise auxiliary carry will reset. So it is used in BCD arithmetic. Next flag is the parity flag. If the result of arithmetic and logical operation has even number of ones, then parity flag will set, otherwise it will reset. So let's consider this example. Here if we are adding 0F and 11, how many 1s are here? Only 1. So 1, that is odd. Here odd parity came, so it will reset. Even number of 1s means even parity. Odd number of 1s means odd parity. So if the result contains even number of 1s, that is even parity, then parity flag will set, otherwise it will reset. Next flag is carry flag. If an arithmetic and logical operation results carry flag will set, otherwise it will reset. Carry also serves as borrow flag. It is useful during subtraction operation. Next one is general purpose registers. So this is general purpose registers. B register, C register, D register, E register, H register and L registers are general purpose register. There are 6 general purpose registers B, C, D, E, H and L. General purpose registers are used for storing information temporarily during execution of the program. These registers can be used as single 8-bit registers or as a 16-bit registers pair. Temporary registers W and Z are used internally. They are not available to the programmer. So in next section, we will discuss program counter, stack pointer, timing and control,
instruction registers and decoder, interrupt control, etc.